Hello guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Abhishek and now today we are going to discuss about exceptions to the law of demand. We have already discussed in our previous lesson what is law of demand, which says that price is inversely proportional to the quantity demanded. That is, if the price will increase, then the quantity demanded will decrease, and if the price will decrease, then more and more people will want that product, so the quantity will increase. So this is what we call as the law of demand. Now, what is exception to the law of demand? Obviously, the opposite of this is known as exception to the law of demand. If we have to define it, we will say that, for example, with a fall in price, the demand falls, and with the rise in price, the demand rises. So this is what we call as the exception of demand. So if the price will increase, then the demand also increases, and when the price decreases, the demand also decreases. So this is what we call as the exceptions to the law of demand. Now there are some exceptions. We will discuss them one by one. So let's go. The first one is, or the first exception is the given goods. In this, what happens is inferior goods whose demand increases with the increase in prices. That is, when the price of the inferior goods which we consume increases as compared to the other higher priced products. So what we do is we take more and more of this product and decrease the quantity of this product. For example, if there is a poor family, they purchase 10 kg rice per month and 20 kg of bajra they consume. So, and the initial cost is 10 rupees for the rice and bajra 5 rupees. What happens is, if the price of bajra increases, that is the inferior good, okay? So what will happen is, they will cut down the consumption of this rice by 5 kgs, say, for example, and they'll buy more and more bajra. So previously they used to buy 20 kg, now they will buy 25 kg. So by this, the demand will increase for bajra. So this is what we call as the given goods. Now the second example is, now the second exception is well-been goods. What that means is that the exception, this exception was first of all was given by an economist known as Thorstein Well-been, who proposed the concept of conspicuous consumption. According to him, there are many people who measure the commodity purely by its price, which means that higher is the price of the good, the more prestigious or the more valuable the item will be. Now let's take an example. For example, there's a person who wants to buy a diamond, or there's a boy who wants to purchase a Harley Davidson bike. So why they are doing it is they want to maintain their reputation in the society, or we can say they want to show off, and they want to afford the product jo sab log afford na kar paye. Basically ye cheez hai. Okay, so now let's take another point. Third one is ignorance and illusions of buyers and customers. What happens in this is, for let's take an example. There's an Apple seller who sells it for 50 rupees, and there's another seller who sells Apple for rupees 100. Now there's an illusion of the people who thinks that he is giving Apple for 100 rupees, so quality of this Apple will be better than that one. So this is the case which we call it the illusion of buyers. Now let's take the fourth point. Now the next point is emergency. Suppose there is a condition in which the war is going, or there is a flood or earthquake or any situation like emergency. So what happens in this is, people will not think that we have for this product I should spend this much money or not. If they have to buy it, they will buy it. For an example, someone is sick, and even if the cost is very high for that medicine, they'll have to purchase it, and they will purchase it. And if they know that there is a war going on, or there is flood, so there will be shortage of food. That's a fact. So more and more people will buy so that they can store them, ki humko zyada baad mein dikkat na ho. So it does not matter whether it is for 100 rupees, or the same product for 100 rupees is available in the market for 200 rupees, we will buy that. So this is the fourth point. Now the fifth point is the necessities of life. For an example, we will always buy milk, food and salt, no matter if its cost rises from 10 rupees to 100 rupees or anything happens. These are the basic necessities of life. Everyone needs food, everyone needs milk and salt, and if you want to drive a vehicle, then obviously you need petrol. So these are the basic necessities. No matter if their price is from 100 to 200 or anything, we will buy them. So these are the certain exceptions to the law of demand. So thank you guys for watching. Share this video, subscribe to my channel. अच्छा लगा तो थम्स अप भी दे देना. थैंक यू सो मच. बाय बाय.